Yo, what is up, everybody? It's Jay the Great here, and welcome back to another reaction video here today. And today, we have an all-time classic video by the great Swagkage, and as you tell the title, this is Top 5 Broken Dragon Ball Abilities. So folks, throughout the historic and illustrious history of Dragon Ball, there have definitely been some memorable abilities, some broken ones, and some ones that cause you to scratch your head. Alright, we have Cell's ability to absorb individuals, Boo's ability to absorb individuals, and through that they become exponentially times more powerful. We have individuals that are immortal. Now, currently, if we want to talk about now, because this video is quite old, we have individuals like Beerus with broken abilities, and basically anyone at the top of the totem pole has broken abilities, technically. But if we want to be more pedantic and look at anything that's possible in Dragon Ball, I mean, we have the Dragon Balls themselves, right, giving you the ability to make almost any wish that you please. We have Sensu beans that literally allow you to restart the match, so to speak. So there are many abilities and just aspects of Dragon Ball that I would say are broken, right? So I'm definitely intrigued to see what top 5 broken abilities Swag has in this one. But before I begin, anyways, really appreciate it. Hit that like button, turn on bell notifications to stay up to date with yours truly. And if you're new and you enjoy, man, and you mess with the kid, make sure to hit that sub button, because once you do, you become part of the family forever. But let's not waste any more time, screen. Let's see what Swag says today.
I can't die. It is impossible. Even if I self-destruct, I will always come back.
Oh. That's fair.
Nice.
So today I'm going to be talking about the top 5 hacks in Dragon Ball, and the best way to describe what a hack is to direct you to the TV Tropes page on a Storybreaker power. In essence, a hack or Storybreaker ability is something that is so unfair it nearly breaks the plot.
The Unstoppable Exodia!
Dragon Ball has quite a few of these, ranging from Garlic Jr.'s complete immortality to Cell and Boo's ridiculous regeneration abilities to the incredibly overpowered results of the fusion dance and everything in between. The only rules for this list are, I am not considering powers based on how powerful they are individually, but rather how powerful they are in the context of the arc or situation they are being used in.
Okay.
I think you'll get what I mean once I start the list. And now, without wasting any more time, I'm gonna jump right into it. Here are the top 5 most overpowered hacks abilities in Dragon Ball. A lot of people like to sleep on Krillin. You know what Krillin can do, though? Cut through anything. Literally anything. As stated by Mr. Akira Toriyama himself, the Kienzan is capable of cutting through absolutely anything. No exceptions. Now, I know there was that one filler where the Kienzan connects with the back of Cell's neck and just dissipates. But that doesn't count. In every other situation, Krillin should be able to cut through literally anybody, no matter how powerful they are, as evidenced by the fact that he was able to cut off Frieza's tail and slash through Nappa's cheek. Both of these characters were significantly more powerful than him at the time, which goes to show that the Kienzan just completely ignores a person's physical defenses. Cell and Frieza both have the ability, and Vegeta seems to as well, but Krillin's the only one who uses it often, and not often enough, in my opinion. If I were Krillin, I would spam the shit out of the Kienzan, because I would be able to kill whoever I wanted with that thing.
Facts,
granted, it's not quite as overpowered later on in the series, when the main villains are capable of completely regenerating, so there's that, but that's why it's so low on the list. Nonetheless, anyone without regeneration powers that gets hit with the Kienzan is pretty much gone. That's ridiculous.
Number 4.
You know, Senzu beans are kind of ridiculous. They can, without fail, heal pretty much all injuries, like, ever. This even works when they're split in half, too, which is something that the Z Fighters seem to forget later on in the series, but that's not the point. See, when the Senzu bean is combined with a Saiyan's ability to get stronger when they recover from near death, things start to look a bit ridiculous. The Zenkai ability sounded cool on paper at first, maybe, but as the series progresses, you begin to realize just how incredibly insane it has the potential to be. Through Zenkai boosts alone, Vegeta manages to go from weaker than all of Frieza's top henchmen to stronger than Frieza's third form over the span of one arc, alone. This is a textbook example of a Storybreaker power, especially because of the fact that it can be exploited, as shown when Vegeta asks Krillin to damage him before getting Dende to heal him. If the main characters of the show decided that they wanted to use Senzu Beans intelligently, you know, like against Cell or something, they would be pretty much unstoppable, because look, yeah, this is a win-win. If you fight somebody who's weaker than you, then you don't have to worry about getting near death, and you win. If you fight somebody who's stronger than you, they beat you within an inch of your life, you eat a Senzu Bean, and you either become stronger than them, or repeat the process until you do get stronger than them.
Pretty
How do you
much.
Stop that?
Pretty
oh,
much.
Wait.
You don't.
Good point. Pretty broken.
Now look, okay, I understand that natural power progression, especially in fictional universes based solely around fighting like Dragon Ball, can inevitably lead the heroes into fighting some pretty ridiculous villains. If the villains weren't powerful, then you wouldn't have any sense of danger, there wouldn't be any threat. I get
right.
it. But there's a such thing as going too far. Majin Buu is just a walking hax. I can't pick any of his abilities in particular because he just has an unstoppable moveset, okay? So all right. Look, let's run through everything Buu can do, just in case you forgot. Buu can manipulate matter. It affects everyone, no matter how powerful they are. And if you don't believe me, he even turned Vegito into candy. He can absorb people at will, even if they are stronger than him, like significantly stronger than him, like Gohan was. And he gains all of their abilities, all of their raw power, and all of their intelligence. He can regenerate endlessly from any injuries with zero difficulty.
Broken.
He seems to have a limitless ki supply. He has more raw power than pretty much anyone in the series save Gotenks, Gohan, and Vegito. He can copy moves on sight, and he eventually gains the ability to warp anywhere in the universe. What the fuck? Alright. Take Buu's absorption ability, crank it up 20 levels, and then you've got Baby's possession ability. This ability doesn't seem to have any limits, admittedly like Buu's absorption ability, aside from the fact that the target has to be injured before Baby can possess them. The thing is, I use injured very loosely because it can be anything as small as a cut or scrape on the target's body, and Baby has them. Like, man, all it would take is a paper cut, and Baby would have you no questions asked. What's
exactly.
even worse is that he can possess multiple people at the same time and make all of them do his fighting for them. So when he has another potential target in mind, he can
like
send the people he's already controlling
Literally.
After that target, and the moment they get injured, which is bound to happen when they're fighting multiple foes at once, Baby can sneak in through the inevitable cuts and scrapes that are gonna pop up on his target's body and then possess them. What's even crazier is that with this possession, Baby seems to make his target a lot stronger. Because Goku, in base form, I might add, had pretty much no trouble whatsoever with Trunks, Goten, and everybody else the Baby had taken over. Meanwhile, Vegeta, on the other hand, was being given quite a run for his money by Baby Goten and Baby Gohan. Yet somehow, Baby Vegeta is able to utterly thrash Goku without even transforming, I might add, when Goku cranks his power up all the way to Super Saiyan 3. With Vegeta possessed, Baby even manages to transform into a golden great ape, and exceed Super Saiyan 4 Goku in power, despite the fact that Golden Great Ape is the precursor to Super Saiyan 4. Speaking of Goku, Baby could have taken Goku over if he wanted to. Why didn't he do that?
That's the honorable mentions.
Alright, before I move on to number one, here are some honorable mentions. Now these didn't make it either because they're just flatly not as impressive as the other hacks on the list. They're not as impressive in context, they're situational, or the characters using them don't fight. But alright, yeah, without further ado, here they are.
Carrot touch. Broken, I'd say, for sure. Devil Might Beam. Time Stop. I mean, of course, this is a classic one. Body Change, another classic. Complete Immortality, duh. course fusion. Broken as hell. Cool in the freezer in general, yeah. Time leap. Temporal do-over plus reality warping. Number one.
Hey, look, Cell might not be the most powerful character on this list, but that said, he definitely has the potential to be the most ridiculous, and, contextually, might be the most powerful villain relative to the strength of the good guys at the time. Granted, that's up for debate. Boo was leagues above everybody, Omega Shenron was too, all that. But see, here, I'm not quite sure how Cell even died.
I can't die, it is impossible!
Because, let's look at this, right? He has regeneration, which he got from the cells of Piccolo, and this is not just any regeneration. No, this regeneration power exceeds Piccolo's by a long shot. It takes no time, first of all. Piccolo's regeneration takes quite a while, whereas Cell's takes pretty much no time at all. Cell can regenerate his entire body from a single cell, no less. And instead of getting weaker like Namekians do when he regenerates, Cell gets stronger thanks to the Saiyan cells he has.
It's an upgraded Piccolo regeneration ability.
The power that Cell receives from his Zenkai boost is proportional to the severity of the injury he sustained. So if he regenerates from a single cell, like he can when he self-destructs, he gets significantly more powerful. See, what's really weird about that, right, is that it's stated by Vegeta that Zenkai boosts only happen in response to an injury that isn't self-inflicted, meaning that Cell's self-destruction shouldn't have netted him a Zenkai boost, but whatever. Since it does, that means Cell could repeatedly self-destruct, regenerate, self-destruct,
regenerate. I guess he's...
And it
excluded from that rule.
There's no atmosphere or Broken. Anything nearby. It doesn't matter how disfigured he is because he has Frieza cells, can survive in a vacuum of space, and can survive any injury no matter how gruesome or disfiguring it is. And on top of that, apparently, his cells can somehow learn techniques of people who are nearby when he regenerates from self-destruction? So he picked up the ability to use instant transmission and can teleport now. And that isn't even mentioning the things that Cell is theoretically capable of. He says to Piccolo that he's capable of wielding a spirit bomb? He might be capable of pulling the Kaioken out, too. He's also a genius, let's not forget that. And he can create little baby versions of himself, all of which are on par with everyone except for Super Saiyan 2 Gohan. Oh yeah, and in GT, he can absorb people like Buu can.
That's it, I'm done, it's over.
So in the Naruto plot holes video, somebody said that...
Alright, that'll be it there. It was actually a very good video. I'm glad I found this oldie but goodie. It was definitely a trip down memory lane, and it definitely reminded me of the broken abilities that we've seen throughout the illustrious history of Dragon Ball. Now, Cell was a good pick. Cell had so many abilities that were so broken, right? But clearly there has to be convenient plot telling, so he lost in the end. But if we're talking about theoretically what's possible, someone like Baby or someone like Cell is not losing, right? In the real world where logic triumphs rather than convenient storytelling, right? Someone like Cell can just continuously self-destruct over and over and over and over again and reach an absurd and damn near infinite amount of power, theoretically, right? So this was definitely a very good video. I definitely think those abilities are extremely broken. The idea of a Zenkai boost, right? Now, in hindsight, right, in the power scaling community or in even the casual fandom, Zenkai boosts are accepted. But when you sit back and really analyze what that is, it's truly ridiculous. Not in a bad way, but just in a general way. It's absurd what these individuals could do. The fact that you can get beaten to death or nearly to death and come back significantly stronger. Right? The idea of building a callus. And I think it also plays into account the thematic aspects of what it means to be a Saiyan specifically, right? Saiyans who are very famous for their Zenkai boost, like Goku and Vegeta and Gohan, etc. Right? So I think that plays into account and blends with the thematic aspects as well. the idea of coming back stronger, right? There's this thematic aspect that is, you know, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And that's literally what happens in Dragon Ball all the time, right? And for Cell, there is no rules for it, right? He can kill himself and still get stronger. So he's even excluded from that. So it's even more absurd for someone like Cell, someone like Boo, that literally absorbs you and not only takes your extrinsic traits, but your intrinsic traits as well. Your intelligence, your personality, etc. So he mimics you and upgrades himself in the process, right? Or Baby, who literally reminds me of a virus, but even worse because it's a conscience virus with a motive. Imagine in the real world if we had a virus with a conscience that's aware of the threats that could destroy it, like antibodies and vaccines and things of that nature. Imagine that. That's Baby in Dragon Ball, essentially. Could spread like wildfire. It could take over a planet. Shit, maybe even the universe, theoretically, of course. And not only does the Baby take over your body, but it amplifies your own abilities. So you're doing his bidding, and also are even stronger than you were before you were taken control by him. That's absurd. That's broken. So, there are many broken abilities in Dragon Ball nonetheless. It was beautifully illuminated by Swagkage in that video. I actually thoroughly enjoyed it. And, side note, I kind of wish Swag made more Dragon Ball videos. You know, I think he makes very good Dragon Ball videos. Of course, he makes very good Naruto videos as well. But I really thoroughly enjoy his Dragon Ball content as well. But yeah, folks, that's going to wrap it up. Very enjoyable talking about the broken abilities and just the realm of possibilities in Dragon Ball, which just speaks testaments to Kishimoto's brilliance, right, as well. But yeah, folks, let me know your thoughts on this. What do you think about all these broken abilities, right? Do you think that they're absurd, or do you think they make sense in this universe known as Dragon Ball? Let me know in the comment section below. I always read your opinions, and I'm actually greatly intrigued by them, so I do read them all. But that's going to wrap it up, folks, and I'll catch you in the next one. This is Jethro Gray signing out. Peace.